Hi, I'm Nicole Young. In this video, I'm going to show you how to edit a landscape photo using luminosity masking in Photoshop. This is one of the hands-on projects in my Layers and Masks Photoshop course. If you'd like to follow along with this edit on your own computer, you can download the practice file that I use in this video. Go ahead and head over to my website. The link is in the description below. I hope you enjoy the video, and if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments. Let's go ahead and edit this landscape photo. For this image, we'll be using luminosity masking. Instead of working with channels, we're going to be working with the color range tool. Let's go ahead and jump right to it. I'm going to go up to Select, Color Range, and in the Select dropdown, I'm going to choose Highlights. I'm going to start moving sliders here until I start to see some of the actual area pop through. If you don't see the black and white preview on the left, go to the selection preview. Oftentimes it's defaulted to none, but you can change it to grayscale and it gives you a better idea of what's actually being selected. You can also change the small preview inside of the color range window. So now I've just kind of reversed what those defaults are. So now I'll play with that fuzziness slider. And I'm just gonna kind of keep moving these around until I feel like I have most of the highlights in the sky selected. So that looks like it's a pretty good selection there. It's selecting most of the sky, but there's still some shadows in the sky that I don't want to be selected. So I'll click OK. I can see that I have that selection inside of the preview, and I'll go ahead and add a curves adjustment. So I'll click that curves icon. And what I'd like to do for the highlights is basically just make them darker. So in that curves tool, I'm just going to click and drag that curve down. Then I'm going to go up to my layer. I'm going to double click the curves name and I'm going to rename it to highlights. Now let's go ahead and adjust the shadows. I'm going to click the image layer. Then I'll go up to select color range. And instead of working with the highlights, I'm going to work with the shadows. Again, I'm just going to move these sliders until I get a good amount of that foreground selected. And then I'll click OK. I'm going to add another curves adjustment. For this adjustment, I'm going to add some brightness and a little bit of contrast as well. Now I'm going to rename that layer to shadows. I'm going to toggle the before and after, and I would like to see what everything looks like. And it looks like there's some areas that the mask is making them look a little too flat, especially in the areas on the mountain. So what I'm going to do is go through each of these masks and add some feathering to them. So I'll click the shadows mask, and then in the properties panel, I'm going to take that feather slider and move it to the right. I'm going to do the same with the mask for the highlights. I'll click that mask, go down to the properties panel, and increase the feather. That just helps to spread the mask out a little bit so the edges of the mask are not as harsh and there's a better transition for the curves adjustments to actually take effect. You don't want to see a harsh line with your adjustments. It just kind of makes things look a little funny. Next, I'd like to add a boost of color, but I only want it to affect the foreground. I'm going to go ahead and add a vibrance adjustment. I'm going to take that vibrance slider and move it to the right. If I toggle it off and on, you can see it's really affecting the sky and also those mountains, but I'd really only like it to apply to the foreground. If I take a quick peek and preview the shadows mask, I'm going to press and hold the Option or Alt key and click that mask. This is pretty much where I want to apply that vibrance slider. So what I'm going to do is copy this mask over to that new vibrance adjustment. I'm going to press and hold the Option or Alt key and then click and drag that mask and release it over the vibrance. I don't really like that it's increasing the blue in the mountains though, so I'm going to select that mask. I'll go over to my image, activate the brush tool with the keyboard shortcut B. I want to make sure I'm painting with black. I'm going to set my opacity all the way to 100. And reduce my brush size. Now I'm just going to brush over the mountain to remove that part from the adjustment. let's take a quick peek overall at everything we've done so far. I'll press and hold that Option or Alt key and click the eyeball next to the background layer. One thing I'm noticing, though, is that the highlights and shadows curves adjustment is actually affecting the color in the image, and it's boosting it a little too much for my taste right now. So I'm going to see what happens if I remove the color from those adjustments. Now, I didn't actually edit the color, but sometimes when you make adjustments to the tone in your image, it also affects the color. So I'm going to select the highlights layer, hold my Shift key, and click the shadows layer. Then I'm going to change that blend mode down to luminosity. If I kind of go back and forth by undoing and then redoing it, you can see that it's making a slight difference in the color. It's fairly subtle, but it seemed like there was just a little too much color saturation for what I was going for. But I did add that vibrance adjustment, and let's see what that looks like now. I think I'm actually going to increase the vibrance setting even more. So I'll take that vibrance slider and push it to the right. I'm even going to add a touch of saturation. And that added some nice effects. But I would like to control some of the coloring in the foreground a little bit more. And to do that, I'm going to add a hue and saturation adjustment. So I'll click Hue and Saturation. I'm going to set the colors I'm working with down to yellows, and then take that saturation slider and push it to the right. This is really only affecting the yellows and most of that foliage in the foreground. I could also play with the hue. Moving it to the left is going to give it kind of more of an autumn look. Pushing it to the right will make it a little bit more green. So I'm going to push it to the right just a little bit, and let's see what that did so far. It made a nice adjustment to the grass in the image. Next, in the hue and saturation adjustment, I'm going to change that drop down to reds. This should make changes to the barn. So if I increase the saturation, I'm going to push it really far to the right. You can actually see where it's affecting the image. I definitely don't want to go that heavy with it. I'm just going to add a touch of saturation. I'm also going to see what the lightness slider does. I don't really like that one, so I'm just going to reset it back to zero. Let's see what this did to the image. It's just a nice subtle adjustment, primarily affecting the color in the foreground in that grassy area. Next, I'd like to add some dodging and burning as well as a vignette, and I can do it all in the same layer. So in the layers panel, I'll add a new blank layer. I'll give myself a little more room there in the layers panel. First, I'm going to name this Dodge and Burn, and also maybe add vignette to that as well. Then I'm going to change the blending mode down to overlay. I still have that brush tool active, but I want to make sure that I'm painting with black. So I'll press X on my keyboard. I also want to paint at a really low opacity because I have that brush tool set. If I press 1 on my keyboard, it's going to change the brush opacity down to 10%. Next, I'm going to zoom out and increase the brush size. And I'll start off by adding a vignette. So I'm just going to make brush strokes all the way around. And then I'm going to release and add another brush stroke. I'm really just using the edge of that brush because that's kind of where the feathered part is. So it's going to be a much softer transition. And I'll do that a few more times. I'm just lifting up and making a brush stroke. Let's see what that looks like so far if I toggle that top layer off and on. I have a nice vignette added, but the center still looks a little too dark. So I'm going to press the X key to switch. So I'm painting with white. Then I'm going to reduce my brush size. And I'm going to start out by doing some brushing over the barn. I'm going to zoom in as well. So I'm just going to make several brush strokes over this area. It just kind of builds up the effect when you do that. So let me toggle the layer off and on. Just watch the barn as I'm doing this, and you'll see how I was really able to add brightness to that area. Next, I'm going to zoom out, and I'm going to increase my brush size and just add one or two kind of sweeping strokes on the inside to make kind of a spotlight effect to the middle. So I'll toggle that off and on, and that really helped to kind of draw the eye to the center of the image. I'm going to make one more quick brush stroke over on the left there to make sure that barn is nice and bright. And I'm also going to fix this spot, got a little too dark, so I'll brush with white over that area as well. To finish this image, I'm going to add an Orton effect. I'll switch to my hand tool real quickly just to kind of make the view look a little bit nicer. Then I'm going to add a stamped layer to the top of the layers panel. I'll use the keyboard shortcut Command Option Shift E for Mac. On a PC, it's going to be Control Alt Shift E. Next, I'll go up to Filter, Blur, and then I'll go over to Gaussian Blur. I want to now increase the radius size so the image is blurred, but I can still kind of see the shapes in the scene. It looks like a setting of close to about 50 is a good look for this, so I'll click OK for that. Next, I want to change my blend mode down to soft light. Now, this is a really intense effect, so I'm going to drop my layer opacity, and I'll go down to around 30%. I'm also going to rename this layer. And let's see what that layer did. That adds some nice kind of contrast and glow. I could even increase the opacity a little bit more to intensify that effect. Okay, let's take a full look at what we've done to this image. I'm going to press and hold the Option or Alt key and click the eyeball next to the background layer. So here's my before image. The color was kind of dull and the tones weren't really balanced. But with the final image, it has a little bit more color, contrast, and the light overall just looks better.